Having a strong belief in something is a great thing and can be very inspiring when you're unmotivated. But there are groups of people out there that abuse the beliefs of those around them and twist their thoughts into practicing dangerous or sinister rituals. Hey most amazing fam, my name is Abby and today I'm talking about top 10 scary cult rituals. Now, this one covers highly disturbing content because these are scary cult rituals. I will mention murder, torture, and sexual assault among a lot of abhorrent topics. You have now been warned. So let's jump right into it with number 10, the Aghori. The Aghori is a religious cult that broke away from the Hindu religion in the 14th century. They believe everything is God and they chase spiritual liberation with their acts. Some of their more tame rituals involve drinking urine and eating human feces, or smothering human ashes on their faces. And those are the tame ones. Their most important ritual to them is called Shavputra, and for it, they need human corpses. That in itself is hard to find in the area as nearly everyone is cremated. Those who aren't cremated, usually because the family can't afford it, are sometimes dumped into the Ganges River. So to find corpses, the Aghori monks fish them out of the river. Now, once they have a dead body, they meditate on it and then chop the head off as it holds the most energy. After that, some of the Aghoris eat the flesh of the body, cannibalistically, unfortunately. Now, this all stems from the belief that they can't please God if they don't do this human sacrifice. They even keep the skulls of the dead as a reminder of the impermanence of life. Quite Hamlet, if I do say so myself. At number 9, the Vampire Clan. So in the 90s, a 16-year-old named Ron Farrell was also apparently a 500-year-old vampire. Identify as you want, man. But Farrell, or Vestago, his vampy alter ego, was a part of a vampire cult. This little clan made up of 3 other teens would engage in rituals where they would drink one another's blood. Does that sound sanitary? No. But is that the scariest thing they did? Also no. In 1996, the 2 boy vampires of the group thought vigilantes of themselves and decided to help out a friend. Farrell had an old friend from high school he went to in Florida, and she told him she was miserable living at home with her folks. And I think I know what you're thinking. Did they kidnap her? No, much worse. The 2 vigilante vampiric teens beat both of her parents to death with a crowbar. Then Visago burned a letter V into the girl's father's body. When he was found out, he received a life sentence for the murders. Number 8, the Birdman Cult. On Easter Island, one era of inhabitants was the Birdman Cult era. The people of Easter Island, the Rapa Nui, came up with an interesting yearly ritual to determine who led them. The eventual leader would be seen as supreme ruler for a year and would be encouraged to take on a bird-like appearance, growing out their nails and shaving their head. But to get that position, their chosen champion would have to succeed in a very tough competition. These chosen champions would dive down tall steep cliffs and swim to an inlet where they would have to grab an egg from a sooty tern or a manutera and bring it back unbroken. So swim all the way back and climb up a sheer cliff face, all with an unbroken egg. And that makes holding an egg in a spoon sound like a piece of cake, right? But the first champion to bring back an egg led to the leader they represented becoming ruler. But obviously many didn't make it all the way through the competition. Many died from falls they took, sharks, or the cutthroat edge of the competition. On to number 7, Freedomites, aka Sons of Freedom. In Saskatchewan, Canada, Dawukober people had a small group within them called the Sons of Freedom. The Dawukober people were a spiritual Christian group that originated from Russia. And the Sons of Freedom were a cult that came out of them during a time of economic tensions. The Sons of Freedom stood for communal living, nudity, and anarchy. They were mainly known for their public demonstrations they performed in the nude. The demonstrations were to show their strong opposition to the materialistic tendencies of society. But they went further than peaceful demonstrations. Completely against the typically pacifist ways of the Dawukober people, they committed acts of terror in the name of their beliefs. They committed arson and bombing to homes, government buildings, churches, schools, and railroads. Number 6, the Order of the Solar Temple. Now, I feel like anytime we talk about a cult here, this one comes up, but it's not without a valid reason. The ritual of this cult was ritual death. After having a ritualistic Last Supper, 53 members killed themselves either by using poison, bullets, smothering, or other causes. In a sect of the cult in Switzerland, in an underground temple, the bodies were found laid out in a circle. Their feet were all touching and their heads, covered in plastic bags, were outwards. Later on, in France, bodies of members from the cult were found out laid in the same manner. Altogether, the cult practices resulted in the deaths of 74 people. Number 5, Superior Universal Alignment. Valentina de Andrade led a UFO cult in the 80s. She claimed she received a message from extraterrestrials that God didn't exist and that Jesus was an alien. She also said that true believers would be saved from the end times, but one group could not leave with her on her spaceship. She believed boys born after 1981 were possessed by evil and had to be purged. With some families, she told the parents of those boys to leave them with other family members and then they could board their spaceship. But her views changed. By 1993, members of the cult are believed to have sexually assaulted, mutilated, or killed at least 19 boys between 8 and 13 years old. Some were even castrated. Andrade herself was acquitted of all charges since she wasn't in the area when the crimes were committed, but her words were enough to persuade her followers. At number 4, the Church of Sacrifice. Back in 1912 in Lafayette, Louisiana, Clementine Barnabet was a high priestess of the Church of Sacrifice. At only 18, she led a cult with a belief system that riches and immortality could be gained through human sacrifice. She wasn't all talk either. She confessed to axing 17 people to death, including two families, because they refused to obey the messages from God, and apparently she convinced the followers of her church to do the same gruesome killings. All in all, the cult in its entirety brutally killed 7 families, a number amassing to 40 people. At number 3, the Ant Hill Kids. Rock Thoreau had a doomsday cult between 1977 and 1989. The way he exercised his power only got worse and worse as time went on. This man who called himself Moses didn't have too many rituals, but the way he disciplined was routinely similar. If anyone did anything he deemed out of line, they were up for punishment, and it didn't take much to get there. Thoreau demanded absolute loyalty, and if that wasn't given, he would get angry and punish his followers. He would punch people in the stomach or hit them with a 4-inch thick club if they ate more than their given portion of food, and not even pregnant women were spared. He forced the members of his commune to break their own legs with sledgehammers, shoot each other in the shoulders, and eat each other's feces or their own. He would have people stand naked in any weather, sun, rain, or snow, if they acted out of line. He even nailed children to trees and prompted others to throw rocks at them. Beyond that, he plucked out people's hairs one by one if he got really angry. At number 2, the Fall Rivers Cult. This cult was led by Carl Drew, a pimp that believed he was the son of Satan. In rituals in the woods, he would speak in voices and tongues. But there wasn't anything too scandalous or illegal in the cult taking place until Drew decided sacrifices need to be made. Human sacrifices. The first victim was beaten and stoned to death while tied up with a fishing line. The next was killed the same way, arranged on a makeshift kind of altar. The last victim chosen was the one that witnessed the first murder. She was going to talk to the police, but Drew found out. He sacrificed her the same way as the other two women. But after that, he also broke her neck with his bare hands, got another cult member to slit her throat, cut an X into her chest, and used the blood to draw an X on the other cult member's forehead. After that, he kicked the victim's head until it came off. And at number 1, the Chicago Rippers. This is another one I've mentioned before, but their rituals are truly disturbing. The core of their rituals was the mutilation and murder of women. The leader, Robin Gecht, and his 3 followers were horrifying in their acts. They would kidnap a woman and bring them back to the leader's apartment. Then the ritual would begin. The ritual involved taking turns sexually assaulting the victim at Gecht's apartment, then removing a body part with piano wire. From there, it got more disturbing. One of the victims survived the ritual and being dumped by railroad tracks. When she was found, she described the group and they were apprehended and brought to justice, thankfully. And on that note, this is the end of the Top 10 Scary Cult Rituals video. And this was definitely a heavy one content-wise, so I encourage you to take a bit of time to look up some cat or dog videos on your phone, maybe have a seat with a cup of tea or some coffee, and think about a fond memory you have and nice things that happen in the world. So send your favorite videos of animals to me so I can cleanse my brain of this one, because Che gets enough animal videos. Give me some. Thank you. Now make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and ring that bell to be notified when our next video is up. And until next time, I've been Abby, and have a good one. I'm out.